Trecem la următorul speaker, care este Sanchenko Oleksandr Volodimirovici, deputat în Rada Supremă a Ucrainei, membru în Comitetul pentru Libertatea de Exprimare din cadrul Parlamentului European. Domnul Volodimirovici este șeful de tineret al Partidului de Guvernare și membru al grupului de prietenie interparlamentară cu România. Domnul Volodimirovici ne va vorbi despre strategia Ucrainei și situația în această țară în ceea ce privește antreprenoriatul social. Domnul Volodimirovici, vă ascultăm.
Thank you. First of all, I'm glad to join to the conference. The themes like social entrepreneurship and youth engagement are really familiar for me. Before I became a member of parliament, I have experience of social entrepreneurship, so I truly feel and understand how it might be and what the sector needs. I will start from the youth engagement, because we as a parliament have a really great news for Ukraine. We renewed the youth law that wasn't renewed more than 20 years. So actually, a few weeks ago, we voted the law 3718. That's ensure the youth participation. We create some structures under the cabinet of minister that will advise to the ministries how to more join youth, integrate in the political engagement and political sphere. And also, we created with this law Ukrainian youth fund that will, as from my perspective, will support the social entrepreneurship as well, that empower young people to start the social enterprises as well. So it's important for Ukraine from the perspective of the youth law and youth legislation, because mentioned one more time, the more than 20 years it wasn't renewed, and it's really a big thing for Ukrainian youth sector. Also, as you mentioned, I am the head of the youth wing of our party, Sluga Naroda, Servants of the People. So I'm really keen to improve and to put on the map social entrepreneurship through the youth policy as well. If to say about the social entrepreneurship, I think we as a country, on the beginning of this process, and that's what I mean. So as I said, stakeholders like social entrepreneurship are gathering to the groups. We have the first studying about the like green paper about social entrepreneurship in Ukraine, white paper. So some cities like Vinnytsia already have the strategy of development of the social entrepreneurship. Indeed, on the national level, yet we haven't, nor from the Ministry of Social Affairs or Ministry of Economy, all Ukrainian strategy yet, but these discussions already started. As well as part of the European countries, we haven't in the legislation the social entrepreneurship. And we start to discuss. We have seven members of parliament who are interested in this sphere. So we have such kind of group of the members of parliament who start in the process of discussion. Do we need the law about social entrepreneurship, or we don't need it? Because to be straight, part of the experts in Ukraine say, so it's okay without it. Don't regulate us. But some others say, please regulate us, because it gives us opportunity to launch the local programs of support, and it helps to understand better who we are and the shape the social entrepreneurship. One more important thing that's we have the initiative from the First Lady, the strategy of creating more inclusive society. In this strategy also is one of the points, bullet points that are important is the starting the social entrepreneurship and creating more inclusive society through development of social entrepreneurship. So it's one of the maybe first parts of the strategy on the national level, because as I already mentioned, Ministry of Economic, Ministry of Social Affairs have such kind of documents, and this strategy gather all the ministries to promote it and to implement it. And from my perspective and the vision of the members of parliament who are interested in this sphere, the answer how to develop, of course, in the middle, because it's about economy, and of course it's about social affairs, and of course it's about the engagement, youth engagement in the civil society, and so on. So as for us perspective, we plan to gather different representatives from the different ministries and to start thinking about the strategy, because nevertheless, will we have the law about social entrepreneurship? Won't have. We need the strategy, like national strategy, what to do with this really important and change and driving thing as social entrepreneurship. To end my speech, I want to say that as I have the experience of social entrepreneurship, I'm sure that the next challenge it will be in the scaling, because I don't know how it's in European countries, but in Ukraine we have quite enough, as for me, like educational programs. But when the question then go into scaling, it's really tough stuff. And as the previous speaker says, really capacity building and helping scaling is really next big question that all the countries will find in the answer, because social entrepreneurship have less opportunity to be profitable because they are creating to do some social stuff and they spending more. So of course they like have less chances or less priority, if to say straight about financially, if to have like just finance approach to them. So it's a big question what funds might be, because in Ukraine we for now haven't some decent fund for social entrepreneurship. Maybe we might to create this, but it's really a big question how to help in them scaling, because education is good, but it's not enough. So to sum up, really glad to gather to the conference to have the floor and to share what we have in Ukraine, and of course to hear the other speakers, because I'm sure that the social entrepreneurship is the thing that could change the world, and it's already changing the world. Thank you.
Mulțumim foarte mult domnului Sancenko Alexandru Volodimirovici pentru această prezentare. Într-adevăr, iată, vin vești bune și din Ucraina, instrumente concrete pentru dezvoltarea antreprenoriatului social în rândul tinerilor. Observ și aceeași dilemă legată de faptul dacă este sau nu necesară o legislație sau reglementări în acest sens. Și în Ucraina suntem la începutul acestui proces, avem primele studii privind antreprenoriatul social, anumite orașe, cum am văzut, Vinița are deja propria strategie în ceea ce privește întreprinderile sociale. Chiar dacă Ucraina este la început de drum în privința antreprenoriatului social, se poate observa acest interes crescut pentru dezvoltarea acestuia. Este bine că există și proiectul EU for Youth, în care este organizat acest eveniment, vine suplimentar cu informare și cu sprijin pentru Ucraina, investind la rândul său ca stat în tineri.
Mulțumim într-adevăr pentru prezentare.